Hi folks, and welcome to DevTrends. Today we're going to talk about Babel 7 and TypeScript and about small webpack plugin that helps you with measuring your build size. So, final release of Babel 7 is finally here. It includes a lot of new features, bug fixes and improvements. And we've already covered the topic in the previous episode of DevTrends, in which we went through all major features of Babel 7 release candidate 1. But now it's fully released, and the topic we didn't cover it enough in previous DevTrends is improved integration with TypeScript. If you're already using Babel in your project and want to add TypeScript, there is now a special Babel preset TypeScript package that will transpile it into plain JavaScript, though you still need a separate type checker for types validation. So let's see how it works. So for this, let's create a new project with new Babel and TypeScript config. So let's, for example, call it TypeScript. Okay, let's do Babel type TypeScript demo and cd init. Here we do npm init yes to all. And let's install some basic packages for Babel and TypeScript that we will need for this. So it's gonna be, first of all, Babel CLI to use Babel in our npm scripts. We will need as well Babel cores, our core Babel packages, of course. And let's set basic preset. As for Babel 7 is preset-env. And let's also add a new preset TypeScript package for our TypeScript compilation. Yeah, Babel preset TypeScript. Of course, we should add TypeScript itself to our dependencies. And for example, let's add some more Babel plugins that will transpile our TypeScript code into plain JavaScript, like Babel plugin proposal class properties and Babel plugin proposal object rest spread. I hope it's correct naming. So let's install and hope everything is correct here. Let's wait a bit. So all our packages are installed now. And let's create some npm scripts. Let's use code and go to packages on. Okay, no. And let's add first a script for Babel compilation of our TypeScript files. So we are calling Babel CLI through Babel. For example, let's create a src folder which will contain our source files, and let's provide our dir, for example, dist folder, and let's tell Babel to compile TypeScript files with extensions flag, so it will be TS and TS6. So let's save. Let's create these folders, src and dist folder. Here are those. And let's, for example, create a new app TS6 file, so it will be React with TypeScript. But here let's just write some default interface for it. Let it be interface to do with two properties key, which will be a number and description. Description, which will be a string. And let's create an object to do with key the row and description like foo. Okay, let's save it. So I think we can add a folder to workspace to see the structure. Okay, so here is a demo, add folder. Okay, so remove this folder old one. Okay, so our src with app tsx in it, and this folder is our for our build files. So let's try our npm script, npm run babel, and we'll see if there is some errors, like something. Oh, of course, sorry, I forgot to add babel config with babel rc file, so babel just doesn't understand what we need here. So let's just copy paste a predefined config I've made earlier. So there are two presets. It's babel env preset and babel preset TypeScript for transpiling TypeScript, and two plugins for using a TypeScript and transpiling these like classes, TypeScript classes, into plain JavaScript, and for example object respread as well, because there are still proposals. So let's save it and let's try our compilation script again with npm run babel. So you can see everything is working fine, and we can see app.js in our dist folder with compiled JavaScript. You see there are no interfaces, so babel strips interfaces and provides you with all plain JavaScript. But for example, if you change redeclare key, so if you change for example key to be like bar, so you can see types are now incompatible, so key is a string here, but in interface it's a number. So VS Code shows correctly the type string is not assignable to type number, but if we do this in babel again, so there will be no errors, because babel just doesn't cannot make type checking, and that's why we need TypeScript. So we need to add TypeScript to our workflow. So we already installed TypeScript package here, and let's add another script. Let's call it just TypeScript. And let's just run TSX here. TSC, I'm sorry. TSC is a TypeScript CLI which does all the type checking and stuff and validates you. If you got some errors in your TypeScript, it just throws your program. And as well, we need to add testconfig.json for TypeScript CLI to work properly. So let's copy paste this from demo repository as well, because there are some compiler options we need to add here. So this is like basic options to use with babel and TypeScript. You can see there's also include key, so we include our src folder, we show TypeScript that our TypeScript models are in src folder like app.tsx. And now let's try to run this TypeScript script with an npm, and you can see there is now an error in our console about incompatible types key bar, you can see. So let's change it to a proper one, to 0, and let's try to run it again. Okay, I think we should disable isolated models for now. False. Let's try again. Okay. So we can see there are no errors in console, so everything is good. And final step, we just combine these two scripts, like let's call it DevScript. And here we run Babel and first TypeScript, sorry, because we need type checking first, and npm run Babel. Let's save it. Let's run it. npm run dev. And you can see that we successfully compiled one file with Babel. Here is it. So this demo will be in the link in the description below. You can check it. So you can see that Babel plus TypeScript workflow has become a lot easier now. However, if you already started a project with TypeScript, you don't really need to add Babel to your workflow, because TypeScript does all the things itself, such as compiling and type checking. But if you want to switch to TypeScript on your existing project with Babel, just update Babel to version 7 and add some TS flavor to it, as we've just done, and that's it. So webpack bundles can become really heavy over time, and we should keep an eye on what we install and include in our project. And there are special tools that help us with this task, like, for example, Webpack Bundle Analyzer, which provides a graph of all node modules dependencies included in the bundle, as well as user scripts. And another tool for this released recently is called Size Plugin, and it is aimed to show current Webpack bundle size as well as how it changed over time. And now let's see how it works. Okay, for this let's create another folder. Let's call it Size Plugin Demo. Let's init new npm project here. Okay. And I think, yeah, it's better, as we need webpack, it's better to take some React webpack boilerplate, for example. I think this one is a good one, because we need webpack config to test size plugin. So let's let's use SSH. Yeah. Okay, let it be not size plugin demo, but just clone this repository here. Okay. React webpack boilerplate. So here's our boilerplate structure. Let's install npm modules here. Okay, our packages are finally installed. Let's try to start a project to see if it works. It should work, because it's popular boilerplate. Okay, our project is running. Yeah, everything is good. So we can see there is no such information like total build size of your application. So we can see there are separate modules, size of separate modules and stuff, but there is no info about like total heaviness of your bundle. Yeah, so let's add a size plugin. Here. Okay, it's installed, and now let's add it to our webpack config. Config.js, yep. So size plugin. Size plugin here. Yeah. Okay. So we're just adding it to our plugin section. Okay, and now let's just start webpack again, and now you can see that there is now a build info, so we can see a bundle size of our application. You can see plus 811 kilobytes, so it's like first build. And for example, let's if we change anything, like let's do a we got, for example, main.js file, which bundles here. And let's just make some random stuff here. Stuff. Okay. And let's console log it, just for fun. And let's save it. And our webpack rebuilds. And you can see it's now 812 kilobytes, so you can see all the changes, all the pluses and minuses you add or subtract from your application. So if you add another file and write another piece of code, you can see all the changes with this size plugin in your webpack output log. So it's very handy stuff to monitor your build sizes. So, as you can see, Size plugin is a small but useful library that can provide you with handy information about your application size and helps you to keep track of its growth. That's all for today, folks. All the links are in the description below. Thank you for watching and stay trendy!